The first step in evaluating sources is understanding the peer review process. There are several types of peer review. First, researchers may ask their colleagues to informally critique their work prior to publication. Another, more formal peer review occurs when an article is submitted to a journal for publication. This is often called a blind review because the author doesn't know who will be reviewing his or her article. During a blind review, a journal editor sends a submitted article to other experts. These experts look for things such as, is the research current? Has the research been done before? Does the author include a thorough literature review? Does the paper's methodology, for example, a clinical trial, or a randomized controlled experiment have any problems? Has any bias been introduced into the study? Are the paper's conclusions consistent with the results from the study? As a student, knowing an article has undergone the peer review process gives both the paper and you as a writer credibility. The second step in evaluating sources is understanding the differences between primary, secondary, and tertiary sources. A true primary source contains direct research. The authors have conducted an experiment, run a clinical trial, or made an observation. A primary source is a first-hand account of new information that has not been reported before. Primary sources tend to be narrowly focused. A secondary source is often referred to as a review article. A review article will examine multiple primary sources. It may look at 10, 15, or even 20 different studies, all on similar topics. It will draw conclusions, summarize information, and synthesize that information. Secondary sources tend to be a little easier to read and a bit broader in scope. However, it is important to remember that although a secondary source has gone through the peer review process, it is someone else's interpretation of primary sources. You may want to go directly to the primary source to verify the accuracy of the secondary source's interpretation. A tertiary source is typically written for a more general, non-scientific audience. Unlike primary and secondary sources, tertiary sources do not go through a formal peer review process. Tertiary sources can sometimes be useful tools to discover new research topics. However, once you've picked a topic, make sure to use primary and secondary sources for your research. Some examples of tertiary sources include newspaper articles, popular magazines, textbooks, blogs, and Wikipedia articles.